Hey guys, I want to touch briefly on Meteor.js today in this video and a little bit about how to use it. So first thing you're going to do is in the address bar, just type install Meteor. It's going to give us the location of the Meteor installer to download. And it's right here. If you're on OS X or Linux, just copy this command here. Open up terminal, clear that out, and then paste it in here. And if you get this error, it means you don't have curl installed, so you need to install it. So sudo apt get install curl. And once curl is set up, you can run the previous command again, and it's going to download Meteor and install it. I already have Meteor installed here, I guess, and so it's removing my existing Meteor installation and it's going to download a new one. So when Meteor's done installing, it gives you a little notice here how to get started. So let's just create an app. Do I have a projects directory already? I do. So I'm going to change directory into projects. And I'm going to type Meteor create to do. And it's going to create a project and a project directory in my current directory called to do. So I'm going to change directory. And then if I list the directory, Meteor has created three files to get me started. So I could type Meteor. And is going to launch the program on port 3000. There we go. So once you get this message, it means the app has been launched. So you can go to localhost on port 3000. And this is our Meteor app. It's got an event handler here for the click me button, which counts the times it's been pressed. But that doesn't really look too great, so I'm going to close this here. And how you add packages to Meteor is you type Meteor, add, and then the package name. So you can browse Meteor packages by going to atmosphere.js.com. And if I were looking for, say, Bootstrap, I would, there's a lot here. However, the official Bootstrap module or package is at TWBS, stands for Twitter Bootstrap, and then Bootstrap. So I'm going to add that to my project like this, and let me go into the file manager here, into projects and to do, and you're going to see the three files that I created for us, but if you hit Control H, you're going to also see a hidden directory titled Meteor. And this is where it stores the packages that we add, and some internal Meteor stuff as well. So we're not going to get too into that. These are the files that you'll be working in with Meteor. So you can open, for instance, the HTML file with gedit. There we go. And you'll see this is the markup. So Meteor works with templates a lot. This isn't an in-depth tutorial, but more just how to get started. Meteor has a pretty awesome tutorial on their website. Just go to meteor.com and you can access the documentation, reference points, and the tutorial to get you started. So that's a basic usage of Meteor in the command line. Typically, it's just Meteor create and then the app name. And once you're in the apps directory, you just run Meteor to run the application, and you can use Meteor add or Meteor remove if you want to remove a package, add to add a package, and then the package name. So thanks for watching this video. I hope you guys found it informative and a good place to start with Meteor. A selling point for Meteor is the fact that real-time interactions are built into its core, so you no longer have to fake it with JavaScript AJAX calls to PHP scripts. Everything's done in JavaScript. It's all real-time, so it's awesome to work with, and it makes things easy as well. So check that out if you're into web application development at all. And I'll see you guys in the next video.